Now, this is going to stop you in your tracks and make you run to your craft room. Embossing powder, don't we just all love it? The melting and those yummy colors, plain gorgeous, but you often end up using just white, black or clear. Maybe out of convenience, or you just don't have a clue what to do with those colored ones. Now, let me show you multiple ways on how you can make your embossing powder stick without any ink and use those yummy colors in the meantime. Paste is a great way to make embossing powder stick, even the ones with some bigger chunks. I have a card and a stencil, and I'm going to apply the paste with a spatula. And for paste always goes, the thicker the paste, the more you need to add to your spatula to get the best result when applying your paste. And if you want to learn a bit more about pastes and how to apply them to get the perfect result, I have a guide for that. And I will link to that in the description box below this video. And once I've done that, I take off my stencil, holding one corner down and lifting the other one up so I can lift it in one take. And then I take another card and I'm going to clean my stencil with a spatula on that card. And this will give you a bit more of a grungy effect, as well as it isn't as clear as for the first card. But it's a simple way to clean your stencil and don't waste any paste. Then I'm going to add on the embossing powder and shake it off. And then I'm going to melt the powder. And the embossing powder with this paste gives an extra super special effect because it gives you some really pretty bubbles that stay soft and squishy even after it cooled down. And this is how the card turned out. The next thing is double-sided adhesive. Double-sided adhesive is another great way to make your embossing powder stick. I just tear the double-sided adhesive to get a nice torn edge. And then I add it to my card. Then I take off the backing piece and then I sprinkle on the embossing powder. And when there are bigger chunks in your embossing powder, just sprinkle on a bit over the complete surface and then fill the rest. So the bigger chunks will stick to that double-sided adhesive as well. And then the finer powder will stick to the rest of the double-sided adhesive. And then I'm going to melt the powder again. And the melting of the embossing powder is always super cool to see. It's sort of zen almost. Seeing that powder go from one color and then slowly move to the melted color is really pretty. Just a little note, something that I have found when making these color charts for a company, trying out lots of different embossing powders with double-sided adhesive, sometimes they do get bubbly and it's not the brand, it's not the sort of powder, but I think it's the color. I can't remember which ones, but some of them did get bubbly and they didn't stick very well to that double-sided adhesive once they were heated. So just so you know, you can come across that and then just use one of the other methods instead of the double-sided adhesive. Next one, another paste, and this is one of my favorites. Just pick some up with your spatula or take any other tool that you want. And then I'm going to spread it on my card. Just spread it over your card like you're spreading a sandwich. You don't need to fill up the complete card. You can leave some bigger chunks, which will create some interest as well. And this way you will get a nice background, hopefully. So I add on the embossing powder again and shake it off. And then I'm going to heat set it. And the melting of the powder is so cool to see. This with a bit of soft, relaxing music. Oh, this will get you in a calm state of mind, hopefully. And this is the result. It's so gorgeous. All those different colors. I like those mixed media embossing powders with those bigger chunks in it. The effect is really super cool. And one thing I always forget about is you can do it on black. And on black it's going to look so gorgeous. So I tried that as well. And then you get such a gorgeous result. And the next technique is with a glue stick, because glue, well, it will make it stick. And just scribble on some of that glue on my card. And obviously you can see very well what you're doing, but this is also fun. It's a bit of a surprise what you're going to get. So I sprinkle on the embossing powder and well, this is a nice scribble, isn't it? And then just heat set it again. And this makes such a fun and playful background. I also think it's a great technique to add a layer to a previous color that you already have on your background. And then something we all have but never use, or at least that's what I've heard, gesso. So let's put that to use and use it in a few different ways. First, I'm going to add some with a tube directly to my card. Now, this is a big tube, so a lot of gesso is coming out, so I'm getting some big blobs here. And maybe a smaller tube would be a better idea, but I'm just going to see what this will bring. So I set that aside and I'm going to add some on an acrylic block. And I'm going to use it as a stamp. I'm just spreading some of those circles on my background and overlapping here and there, picking up some of those bigger blobs that are on some circles where there's a bit more, to load that acrylic block again so I can make some more circles. And in case you want to learn some more about gesso, I have a class on that and I will leave a link in the description box if you'd like to check that out. And then I'm going to add on the embossing powder and I shake it off again. And this will give you another fun and incredibly cool background. I also added a powder to the other background. And this is actually a bit weird because the gesso is still moving. And this creates a really fun background. In case you want to try this, make sure you leave the gesso alone. Even after the embossing powder is cooled down, the gesso still will be wet, especially the bigger blobs. And if you touch them, the gesso will just pop out from under the embossing powder, a bit like you're squeezing a pimple. Ooh, that's gross. Anyway, if you don't want that effect, then leave it alone until it's completely dry, let's say overnight or so. Let's try another one with gesso, this time with a sponge with some big holes in it to get a nice pattern on that background. I just added a bit of gesso straight on the sponge and then I start pouncing or stamping with it. And just make a nice pattern on that background. And then I add the embossing powder and I shake it off again and I'm going to heat set it. So this will give you another really cool background. Nice and grungy, and if you don't like that, well, you can do something else. And these are the three backgrounds made with the gesso together. And I think they are pretty cool. You can use them as your base layer or you can just layer them or add them on a colored layer. Well, lots of options. Have some fun with it. The next thing is one of my favorites because it's so super simple. It's water. And I'm showing it in the distress layer because I'm going to spray some on a piece of plastic wrap. Then I turn it over, add it to my card and I pounce on it just a tiny bit. I don't squeeze it on. I don't want my complete background wet. And now let's see what that's going to be. So I didn't touch the complete background as you can see, but it gives a pretty interesting background this way. But with water, you have to work fast. And if you don't work fast enough, then you get this. A lot of the powder will get blown off by the air of the heat tool. So you can still see that pattern, but it's not completely filled like it was when I added the embossing powder. But if you get this, you can just add some more. Just repeat the steps and do it again. Add some more of that embossing powder and see what you get now. And when you want to work fast, make sure your heat tool is preheated, ready to go, so you can heat set it right away. I think this makes another cool background. And now I'm going to spray some water drops, and this is so hard to see. I'm going to show it up close, which makes it a bit easier to see. And then I'm going to sprinkle on my embossing powder as fast as I can, and then shake off the excess, and then to the heat tool to melt it right away. And what I like to do is go over all the parts a little bit, so it's already starting to melt, making sure that the powder doesn't fly away. With water, you just have to work fast, just be prepared, and then get ready to rock. And next, double-sided adhesive tape. You know I like tape, so why not use tape on your background? So I'm going to add a few strips of tape to my card. And I cut off the bits that are sticking out so I have the complete length of the tape. I've taken off the backing and then I add some embossing powder. And then I'm going to melt my first layer. And next I'm going to add some more strips of tape, repeating the same steps again, adding my embossing powder. So in the meantime, I've melted the pink embossing powder and I'm adding some more strips of tape. And now make sure, and this is important, make sure that you press down that tape really well, or you don't get those straight edges when you remove your tape backing. Part of that tape can be lifted, so you get those wonky edges. Now, that also can be something that you're going for, so if you like that, then don't press it down too well. And then just melt the powder again. And this will give you a bit of a see-through effect, which is also very cool. Now, whether you have run out of ink or you just want to try something different, this is so much fun that you just have to try it. I have more ideas with embossing powder for you right here in the playlist in case you need some more inspiration or if you just want to binge watch. And as always, make sure to keep on crafting because it's fun. It's fun, Bibi. Yay. Moet je in de camera kijken, daar. Oh, daar zijn de mensen. Oh, ik hoorde het ook. Oh, waar was dat? Waar was dat? Doe gewoon. Ja, ik vind het ook mooi. Is mooi, hè? Is mooi, hè? Ja, is mooi. Moet je daar kijken, daar in de kamer. Ja, vooruit. Go, go, go. Goed zo. Knap hem uit. Yay.